it was also assumed that everything was wrong in India. I remember when in the early years of Manushe, whenever either I traveled abroad or I was interviewed even here by journalists, the narrative that they tried to impose on my life was that of total subjugation, oppression, and as though for the first time in history, some of us were waking up to new dawn. And it was also assumed that we were inspired by the feminist movement in the West. I was very often called the Kate Millett of India, the Gerda Lerner of India, and all the rest of it. Also, I got tired of being asked questions like, have you had an oppressive father? Did he let you study? How did he treat you in comparison to your brothers? It was assumed that if women in India escaped being killed in their mother's womb, if somehow escaped female infanticide or feticide, then they would end up being treated very shoddily by their parents. And if they managed to somehow grow up and got married, then they would be beaten up for dowry. And if they were lucky to have escaped death at the hands of abusive husbands, and if they were lucky to have grown up sons, then they would live under the shadow of their husband and then later on their sons. They could never have any independence or autonomy. And I would even be asked questions like, how many satis have you had? Was your grandmother burnt on her husband's pyre? I mean, things like that. Now, when I looked around and I looked at my own life, nothing of the sort had happened. I had the most doting father who treated me better than any son anywhere in the world could be treated. At age 5, I had more freedom than any man could have had at age 55 anywhere in the world. So my parents, far from discriminating, gave me far more freedom, unconditional support and love than they gave to their sons.